You've got your bomb computer, so that's a black box with a green framework around it.
Sorry, you need to throw that in.
It's alright. Count.
Yeah. Okay, so when we start up the starboard side first, so it'll be number 3 and number 4 engine. And then on the port side, it'll be number 2 and number 1.
Sit on the last way. Sorry, where are you?
I thought I was trying to hop
it. Okay.
Thanks.
Squeeze on through there. That's fine.
Hello. You're busy all day, we wait for you. You're passing on the way out.
Yeah, I am.
Everybody's getting out of front.
No, no.
So.
Yeah.
How many revs do you need to take off?
Well, they go up to 3,000 RPM.
And that would be maximum?
That's full RPM, yeah.
Yeah. And we do, you took it to 2,000?
Yeah, 2,000, that's me. Zero boost.
Yeah.
3,000 RPM, the boost is a lot higher.
Yeah. So when it be cruising at like an altitude that was normal, how many revs would it be doing then? Would it, you'd slow it down?
Yeah, you'd be probably about 1500, 1700, yeah. Something around there.
Yeah.
But you're coursing the blade off as well. The blades are your variable pitch. So at the moment they're sat in fine pitch.
So can you control that, yeah?
Yeah, you've got your pitch control levers down here.
Oh,
so you can control the pitch of the blade.
So do you control them all together or separately?
Separate engine, yeah. Each engine separately.
What effect would that have?
It's a little bit like fifth gear on the car. It reduces your RPM but keeps your speed.
Yeah.
So your engine's using less fuel effectively for the same.
Yeah. But other than that, it does nothing. I'm just wondering.
Well, it probably helps you take off, doesn't it?
You take off in fine pitch.
Yeah. So that's where you benefit, but then you cruise, like you said, like a sixth gear or something.
Yeah.
Oh, right, I get it. Okay. Wow.
Mm.
So is it.
Unbelievable.
Like when you take off, they're angled more. So
no, they're angled as they are now in fine pitch.
Yeah. Got you. I could never understand how they. It's just air over the wind, isn't it?
Yeah, just lift created by the shape of the wind.
Yeah, don't think of it too, because it's actually so simple, it's quite scary, when it?
Yeah.
It is really scary when you think about it, and I'm thinking, that's all it is.
Yeah.
Because that is actually it, it's the different path of the air from the top and the bottom, isn't it?
It's just the
difference in the travel between the two, and it's like, is that it?
Amazing.
It's quite scary.
And the thing, when they say about stalling,
yeah.
And you think, well, how the hell can you stall if you're going forward, and so you've stalled because you're not going forward quick enough.
No lift, is it?
You lose momentum, and there's less air going over the wings, so there's less lift, so the weight of the aircraft.
Yeah.
I suppose it's same as a Formula One car, isn't it? If you think about all the downforce the Formula One has, same thing, because they can't.
And you work to go faster.
Yeah, they've got to go. Yeah, when they go faster, it means they can go faster, if that makes sense, isn't it?
Yeah,
because they get more downforce.
So this looks like a seat back.
That's the backrest of the engineer's dicky seat. Yeah.
And where was the navigator actually sat then?
There was a bench seat that bolted through the floor. So just where you're stood, right. That's where the seat bolted through, yeah. The trouble is it was such a big obstacle that we had to take it out.
Yeah.
Obviously, so they'd come in, then it would kind of go into place. So once they're flying.
No, it was there. The only thing it did was rotate 90 degrees the top of it.
Oh, so you're right, okay.
So you'd still have all the framework there. You'd have to straddle it basically and walk up the side.
Oh, somebody's turning it around, aren't they?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think that's probably the best way of doing it.
Don't reverse very well.
No, or if not, you have to spin it around in a circle, which would be. So could you put one in forward and one reverse?
No, I can't.
Okay, I was going to say, thank you. Quite odd. It's lovely to see, isn't it? But it's quite scary to think that this was their day in the office.
Mm.
And they got on here and went to work in this.
Yeah.
It's quite a small little box, isn't it?
Good.
Now that's what you call a little bit good. What an experience.
Yeah.
Fantastic.
Brilliant.
Ace.
Yes, the amazing thing is the lack of space in there. How would you get out when it's on fire and it's out of control?
Corkscrewing and trying to get out of an escape hatch.
Full of hydraulic fluid and the amount of climbing and putting your head in the right place to get under different things. Just makes you admire those guys even more. Just amazing. Amazing experience.